Moses and all those who are called John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and in life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness. The darkness has not overcome it. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. Fire in the Bible is a powerful symbol for holiness and as well as protection. As a metaphor of God's holiness, it may also purge or purify. In some parts of Scripture, it represents divine action, with God Himself presented as a consuming fire. In reference to God's action, fire was frequently a symbol of destruction associated with the wrath of God and His jealousy. In the book of Psalms, fire is described as God's servant, brought into existence to serve God's plan and purpose. This same description can be found in the book of Isaiah, where it says, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned. The flame shall not consume you. The bush fire continues to destroy places in the world today, killing people and animals homeless and in great pain. Symbolically, from another angle, the same flames and heat that we see in the fire occupy unforgettable memories of damage and destruction in the lives of many people around the world. Yes, at all levels, political, social, economic, cultural and religious levels of our common life. From the beginning of time, up until we are. In the midst of a flames of turmoil and heat, of hate and destruction, in the world today, including our very own beloved Fiji, is the eternal voice, the voice of God Himself. I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. And into that eternal and living voice of God, we now commit all those